Good afternoon. It's a beautiful day for a change. It's supposed to be a beautiful day tomorrow. I've just spent about 2.5 hours in the bedroom, and the bedroom still looks like the aftermath of Armageddon in there. A term I usually say is looks like a bomb's dropped, but that's not really appropriate these days, is it? Maybe 20 years ago I'd have used that term, but I don't like to use that one now. Anyway, I'll show you what I've been up to. There we go. Can't get more organised than that. Which actually leaves all this space here. I'm going to have to get some filler. Because I've got so many holes dotted around like this where I've had... These actually had speakers on the wall, that's what they were for. Took that shelf down just so as I could pinch the brackets to put up there. And yes, I know that shelf looks like it's on the piss. But, it's actually level. According to my spirit level, that shelf is level. And I checked that spirit level by putting it on that shelf. That shelf is level, so... If it's out, then my spirit level is out. But, that shelf looks perfectly level. I've got a feeling it's this wall. I know for a fact that wall's off anyway. Yeah, it's all plugged in, all connected. We even made a little hole in the shelf to put all the cables through. All three of my consoles are up there. If I get any more consoles, I've got no fucking idea where I'd put them, but... And of course I've sat the controllers on there, so I can literally just, whatever console I want to play, I can just grab a controller. I have a second controller for that, which I've actually got plugged in and tucked up there. You know I've got plenty of controllers for that, but I need a second one for the Master System. So, I can play two players on the Mega Drive and the PS1. If I ever have anybody come over that wants to play them. But, it's looking a bit rough. I might just stick a dark varnish or something on these just to make it fit in with the other wood a bit better and that'll look a bit better. And so I also had the issue that this is a little bit thicker than that. But it's up there. It's sturdy. Oh, and I got that under there, because I took the top off. The top was busted anyway. I think I showed you before where I had it all patched up with parcel tape, so I just broke it off, because I thought, what's the point? And that gave me enough room just to slide that under there, so that solved the storage problem of this. So, next task is to repair the shelf by putting the bracket back on there and hopefully put it up on this wall. Probably not as low as the original one was. I can go a little bit higher, I think. I'll take this down out of the way for now. I'm not sure if I'm going to use this or the other one. Wherever I put the other one, it's in this shithole, so I'm going to go to bed. Can't believe Nemo is actually asleep on my dirty laundry. Poor bastard. So yeah, I've actually had quite a productive day today. Now, if I had the tools, I'd have done nice fancy joints and whatnot, but I'm not proud in that it does the job. So, as I said, I've actually got this whole area now. A nice large area. I could put my record deck up here now, and my plan will be to put one speaker up there when I get the speakers, and one up there. And have the record deck probably sitting somewhere in the middle for now. Yeah, I'm actually happy with that. It is pissing me off that that shelf looks on the piss, but I can assure you it's not. Although I did forget to put the hole in the shelf before I put the shelf up, so that made things a little bit more awkward. And the screw holes didn't line up there for some reason. I can never get the screw hole. At least on when I put a shelf up, there's at least one screw hole that's not lined up with the original hole in the bracket. I don't know what I do, but I just stick the pencil in, you know, and I do a nice big circle. Get the drill bit and put the centre of the drill bit right in the centre of the mark I made, and there's always one that's off. But I cheated on there, I just stuck the bloody screw in at an angle. Sod it. Right. Well, I am sweating. It's taken me so long because I end up getting so hot and sweaty that I go into the lounge just to cool off in front of the fan. I have had the radio playing. I've got the radio playing online. Musical. Yeah. But you can do that with many radio stations nowadays. You can either listen to them through a radio, or you can, they have a thing where you can where they stream their radio station online as well. So I've got my local one playing. I just crank the volume down, you know, and I don't get copyright strikes from YouTube. And that is a smelly, dirty tea towel. That's why I'm using it as a sweat rag. It's got to go in the wash anyway. I'm not using that to wipe any dishes up with. I might be an untidy bastard, but I'm not that unhygienic. But, I did put a post on Facebook. Taking a photograph of my corner there. Because it is a common stereotype that people with autism are very disorganized and untidy. Well, yes and no. At least for me, it's yes and no. Because it depends what it is. As you've seen, my Lego is extremely well organized, my bike parts are organized, and now my computers and whatnot, and consoles and everything are all organized as well, or at least getting there. But I am untidy, messy, and disorganized everywhere else. You know, there's clutter and things kicking around, and look how untidy my kitchen is. So at least for me, yes and no, depending on what it is. My hobby's organized. And a friend of mine on Facebook posted about, or shared a post that said, I just saw a comment that said you cannot have a female James Bond. And then it goes on to say, I can assure you, you can. Well, I don't see why not. Part of me want to say, well, James Bond, you know, James Bond has to be male, but maybe James retires and his sister takes over, so therefore, you could have a female Bond. After all, they've now got a 15-year-old black girl playing Iron Man, you know, Iron Man, played by a girl. Go figure. But, so, why not? I saw the photo of the girl that's playing Iron Man, and she's got, you know, the stereotypical sort of afro hair. How does she get Iron Man's helmet on? That would go for any woman, you know, with the sort of a perm or any sort of bushy hair. How would they get Iron Man's helmet on? I don't know. You know, it's like in the cartoons where everything just seems to be so compact, and you take it off and it just goes boing. Oh, but I thought I'd just take a break what I was doing in the bedroom and I'll get that shelf put up. And And I think that would be it for today. Well, at least up here. Could go downstairs and finish off the rally, Max. I wonder if that, my boss, well, I call him my boss. He's the owner of a lot of the Facebook groups I admin. I do a lot of admin work for him. One of them is the Classic Car Graveyard. Petrol Heads, I think, is one he changed the name to. Ford Transit Lovers from Old to New. Ghost Towns and Abandoned Places, which people get confused and think that they can put ghosts up, but it's not actually about ghosts, it's about abandoned towns and buildings. But I've actually thought about seeing if it's an idea to change that and add the paranormal to it, or just keep it as it is. Good question. We've got loads. A lot of them are sort of dead groups now, but yeah, he had anyway, he replaced the brake blocks in his and his kid's bike, and even though they went on a 10-mile ride, he said the brakes are just barely stopping them. They're not as sharp as they should be. They could still need bedding in. He said he did all the wash the wheels and whatnot, just in case, you know, there's some grease or something on them. But aside from worn out rims, he said they looked fine, but I can't tell without actually looking at them. So it's a possibility, but maybe they need bedding in longer than 10 miles. I don't know what it is for V-brakes like that. But I know with disc brakes, you're supposed to do 10 hours worth of braking to bed them in. I'd probably say do the same with all brakes, just to be on the safe side, you know. It's just like on a car, you've got to bed them in when you replace your pads and discs. So, yeah. I'd say give it a little longer to bed in and see what happens. I know it took quite a few rides on my Claude Butler to get that rear brake to bed in before it actually started having any decent effect on my stopping valve. Right. I've got a couple of hours or so to pass before Mum arrives. She's doing that some training. She's got to go to Lidl's when she comes back this way. So I think it's time to go put up one last shelf. I'm making a mess, so I might as well do it now. So part of me can't be asked. Part of me has had enough for the afternoon of messing around in there, but get that done, get it all dusted down. Then this evening, I'm going to sit and put stuff up on eBay. I've got to pick 10 items. I'm just going to double check that. 10 items was my limit. I don't think it's changed. It's stupid. eBay keeps emailing me at least once a month saying, improve your seller status. or reputation or whatever they'd call it, I can't remember now. And you know, by selling, well, take my fucking nibber off so I can sell more, then I might be able to improve it. I still got anything for sale. No, I haven't. I must have missed the email that said it stopped, so I'm going to re-list that one. So I've got 9 items now. Or £100, whatever comes first. But, I suppose eBay couldn't, you know, take that off. I suppose it's all done automatically. Listed that, and it's still saying 10 items, so I'm going to refresh. Yep, £995 now. Because I've got some binoculars, I've got an old camera there, there's a couple of bits there I'm going to try. My laptop to do, but I can sit. That's all quiet stuff I can sit and do this evening. I want to get the noisy part done. Anyway, 16 minutes. I'm a chatterbox, I know. So, of course, like walking into an oven when you come out of that, out from under that fan, or in front of that fan. I always say under that fan for some reason. Right, I've got my arse into gear, and I think I'll see if I find like a little cheap pot of filler for these holes and get them filled in. I need to redecorate at some point. Anyway, I haven't, you know, I've been here 7 years and it's only been painted once. Anyway, we have a shelf up. Now, before I put the drill and that stuff away, I did sort of toy with the idea of putting the spotlight up. The problem is that I've got which spotlight do I use and where do I put that and the switch? It's a good question. Put the switch under the shelf, and if I don't use the clip-on spotlight when I can find it, here it is. I could. That ain't good. That's my lead sign. I want to find somewhere to put that up as well. I'll do what Mum said and save it for Christmas and put it up for Christmas. Could do what I did in the other room and just put the spotlight up there like that. And just run a cable into the switch and then down the wall. Might actually help if I actually point the camera at the light. Somewhere here. I think that's probably my best option, or that's the other option I've got, but I don't like that one. I think I'll go with putting it on the edge of that. I'm not going to use the bulb that's in it. One's got to be bottom, one's got to be the side, but I don't know which one's which. I'll just wire it the same way they've done that. So, I need to get screwdriver. That would be a handy dandy thing to have. Let's have a look, see what have I got in here. One of those, let me try that. I want to use a black wire, not a bright orange one. Bright orange one stands out too much. That was a good cord grip. Mind you, I could find an old plug. I could pinch one out of that. Pull that off. And if I screw it to the shelf, I've not got to drill any holes into the wall or anything like that, so it'll make life a little easier. I've got that ready. This I will now screw somewhere up here, like that, and stick a couple of screws on either side. Cable comes in the back. I've got some sticky back clips. In fact, I've even got, somewhere in this shit down here, I've got some flat, over here I've got some flat flex. Somewhere, is it this one? It is. Cut a piece off of there, and I could even pinch a cord grip out of that. Don't really need a cord grip, but I'd rather it was there. Right, so that's the plan. Shit. Bloody back box for me switch is down in the shed. Oh well, I'll get this light up and a wire on the light at least. Yeah, I'll... Well, I've got most of it wired up. I've just got to sit on the floor and just fit one of these. It's a case of putting blue wire there, brown wire there, blah blah blah. But I thought before I'd button up the switch, I'd just show you what I did there. Just about seeing there, the two blue wires are connected together with connector block. And I've got the live wire to the light connected at the bottom of the switch in L1. And power coming in, I've got in the common. So I'll go ahead and button that up. And like I said, I just sit on the floor down here. There, I got that torch, because the other one's still downstairs in the shed and I can't be asked to throw me boots back on just to grab that. So I'm just going grab all the bits and pieces of what has that got a 3-amp fuse in it? It has indeed. Where are my wire cuts? I've got to find the cable, which is somewhere under there. I've also misplaced my red pair of wire cuts. I had them in here because I was doing that, so where have I thrown them? I've got a fan on in here as well. I've got two fans in the flat running now. Oh, I found my cuts. I'm just going to go and grab a pair of pliers. Just so as, I can strip the wires a bit easier. Yeah, I've got that one again. It always tilts backwards like that, and it pisses me off. Right. I should, I hope, be going to Mum's tomorrow. A really addictive game of Tetris. You can use a computer mouse to control it. The other one I used to play, you could only use a keyboard. Anyway, I'm going to park my ass down here on the floor. I am going to stick another cable clip or two in there. So I can't find them at the minute, and it's a bit too late to go banging them into a wall anyway, so I'll find some up, and when I do, I'll just bang them in. maybe tomorrow before I go to Mum's or something. Right. So, I'll talk to you in a bit. Hopefully I can show it working. It's a bit dark, but it does work. Switch looks like it's switching around the wrong way, but it's only because I put the switch upside down, but it is switching in the correct orientation. Not that it matters, but for some reason it just seems like the standard that way is off and that way is on. I don't know why, but that just seems to be the standard. Like I said, it doesn't matter. I suppose it's been done that way for so long, they figured it probably confused people if they suddenly started to change it. Right, so that's done. Brick or deck is in place. I've just got to clean all that down. There's no electronic shop in town, so I don't think I can get contact cleaner in town. May have to be an online job to get that. Put the cat's towels back on the floor, yes. I'm letting Nemo have those two towels. There is bed. Got some stuff I want to fit. I want to fit on eBay. That I want to put on eBay, not fit on eBay. A couple of things on the bed, an old camera and some binoculars that were given to me. I don't know, they've got to be worth a £2 star each. I'll auction them. I'll probably only get £2 each for them, but who cares, they're a given to me. I thought it was 8 o'clock, it's 9 o'clock. The bike wasn't locked up, and I still had my pants on. I'd have gone down to see if there's any more freebies down there before they all get dumped or whatever, but don't actually know if I can be bothered, to be honest. No, I could. It wouldn't take me 5 minutes just to throw my pants on, but I've got to throw boots on and trek downstairs, unlock the bike. I didn't see anything interesting there yesterday apart from the record player anyway, so I've been a busy bee. I did a lot more than I intended, to be honest. Let me just turn the light on again. I actually intended just to get this in and get that and that moved. I didn't think about putting a shelf up or anything. You know, or that shelf up or a light up, so I think I've actually achieved quite a lot. I have to do a bit of strengthening of some of a couple of these legs, I think, because there's a bit of wobble to it, but it's definitely holding a lot of weight there. I mean, that's not light up this end. For starters, there's a television up this end, a television there, so it's actually supporting a lot of weight. I did put a little brace section in the back there, as you can see, a little angle piece. But I couldn't do it at the front, because then I wouldn't have been able to get these back in, so. But, seems alright anyway. It's alright that, in that direction. I put an angle brace in there. Need to empty it all off, actually, and put the braces towards the back if I'm going to do it. Might just stop it rocking a little bit from left to right, that's all. If I've got anything in here I could use, I'd throw some bits in the bin, but I could cut that up and use that, I think. Nothing else long enough? No. Oh well. Going to Mum's tomorrow, if that wood is still down by the workshop, I'll see if I can salvage anything that I can use just to cut some angled pieces out of. Could actually put some right up in that corner. can't get the TV out of there anyway. It's got to come this way, and this lot's got to come out anyway, so it's actually tempting to put that old radio on there, the old valve radio, tube radio, because I ain't going to do anything with it. I know Mum wanted me to keep it and fix it, but I don't know. This feels a bit beyond my skill level, to be honest. It would be nice, though. I mean, it was working until it decided to blow a cap. Yeah, at least the cap vented. I do like that about capacitors. They do vent rather than go bang, most of the time. I suppose it depends what you've got as well. Or what type of capacitor it is. But a lot of them do just vent. That's what the little crosses for on the top of an electrolytic cap. It's designed so when they do start bulging, you know, if they get too hot and the electrolyte starts bubbling, it'll burst through the top. So it fails in a controlled manner. That's the idea of it. Instead of just building up and going bang. Oh, so nice to be in front of the fan. Oh, I've got to tell you. When Mum finally turned up, well, in fact, I walked over to Lidl's to save her coming here and picking me up, just to go back that way to Lidl's. And once we'd done at Lidl's, we went round to Sainsbury's, because Mum needed a few bits in Sainsbury's. Why don't we shop in the one store? Because it's actually cheaper to shop around. But anyway, coming out of Sainsbury's petrol station, I'm not sure what year it was. I think it was definitely early to mid 60s. Corvette convertible was driving out in the garage, and that actually looked rather beautiful. Not normally a sort of car I'd go for, but if I was actually on the market to buy an American car, that would be one I'd consider, to be honest. But yeah, I've seen quite a lot of old cars lately. It's that time of year. As soon as you get a bit of sun, the classics come out. I wonder if it'll be at the classic American car show at Cromer in August. You get a few British ones there, but it's mostly meant as American classic and customs. That's what the show's meant for. They do get quite a lot turn up. If I want to sort of talk Mum and Stepdad into going, maybe. My brother probably won't, because he'll be working. My sister will be off doing her own thing. But if not, I'll probably get on the train and go myself. I've already missed a number of events this year. Oh well, I was just watching something on there, and it looks like it's a Hiss Take Out of the Psycho series on YouTube. And something is smoking. Oh, it's a firework, I think. Not a clue. I know my late granddad worked for Plumley and Gaze in town way back in the day, and that's one of their steamrollers that has been rescued and restored. Anyway, I'm going to shut the video off here because I'm not going to be doing anything for the rest of the evening. It's too hot. I think I've done enough for today anyway. I made some progress in the bedroom. That's the main thing. I just got to wait till Thursday gets here. Yeah. So, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll talk to you all tomorrow when I get back from Mum's. Bye-bye.